Welcome to an edition of Let's Play Farming Simulator 2013 on The American Farm. Alright, so we got a couple things going on today. It's currently 6:20 in the morning. It's supposed to be sunny today. This is good. And our soybeans are ready to be harvested, like so. So I got my combine set up over here, ready to start harvesting our soybeans. Soybeans don't produce any straw or anything like that, so don't have to worry about that. So it should be a quick, relatively quick harvest. So let's just set him up here. Set him on the first course. Just start the header there. Start driving. There we go. Excellent. So he should start doing his thing. Don't know why. Oh, we got, it's like corn coming out of the back. Alright, so he's doing his thing. Oh, this is going to fill up a lot that faster than I thought it was going to. Holy cow. I'm actually going to slow him down. Wow, he's even doing... Alright, so I guess I don't have much time. Not as much as I thought, apparently, because that... I don't know what the coefficient is for this map, but that's a lot more soybeans than I thought it was going to be. Oh, man. I have to double check, actually. But I don't have any mods that would actually adjust that, but that's a lot of soybeans. Are going to be a lot of soybeans, but that's good. Because we have a great demand for soybeans coming up in 4 days, this is good. And soybeans also sell for, at a regular price, of $900 a ton, or $963 at the mill, or $991 at the port. Wow. So we're going to go ahead and hold on to those soybeans until they are ready to be, or until they're on great demand, basically, and then we're going to do a couple trips. And we should make a good chunk of change there. Alright, so we have our harvester going on over there. And over here, we have our New Holland. He's way over here. He's currently cutting some more grass because the grass grows back super quickly on this map. And everything grows really fast on this map. It's a big change from the newbie farm. So New Holland's over there. He is currently just cutting the grass because we can't put the Ford on it. Because it doesn't quite have enough horsepower. The Ford only has 74 and that mower needs 80 horsepower, so a little underpowered. So looks like it's going to be a heavy crop this year, so we don't want to push the Ford past its limits. All right, so just start the Ford up here. So currently this thing's full of silage at the moment, or what they consider silage for pigs at least. And our pigs currently have, I don't need this, let me just drop this bale spike. Don't want to use up the extra fuel on a bale spike we're carrying around. There we go, let's just leave that there for now. So we currently have 89 pigs now. They're at 31% productivity. They have 3 days worth of silage. They got 2 days worth of wheat, and their manure is full. So we have 100,000 liters of manure here. 100,000 liters of manure, which is kind of crazy. And they have 100,000 liters of liquid manure there already as well. So because there's 100 liters of manure, and we can actually sell manure on this map. That's quite a bit, actually. $50 a ton. We don't have anything. I could just buy a bucket. There's no way I'm gonna deal with that with a bucket. It would just take too many trips. I'm not a bucket type person, as I'm sure you're aware if you've watched any of my previous series. I'm more of a conveyor belt person. Alright, so let's just top this Ford off initially. Here we go. Might as well have a full tractor, and then we'll set him on his course. Where are we here? F13 unload. Set him to the first point. Pick our combine, which is when we have one. There we go. And I believe our combine's probably going to be full. Yeah, I think he's full already. That's all it took for him to be full, apparently. Wow, that is crazy. So apparently... there's a very high yield of soybeans on this particular map. They can yield relatively high as well, so it's not It's not impossible for this to happen. I'm just going to set him on his first waypoint. Actually, no. No, we're not going to do that. Let me just back him up first. And then we're just going to hop into the combine quickly, unload. There we go. So load some of these, and he's going to start again. So what I'll do is I'll just set him to nearest point now. And there we go. He's going to drive behind the combine. This is good. So we're going to go ahead and hop back into the combine because he's going to need to be unloaded, and this combine does not unload automatically via course play. Makes me a bit sad, but eh, it's fine. Ooh, it makes, apparently they look like corn, but they don't quite look like that in real life, but I understand why they've done it. This Ford doesn't know where to go, apparently. Nope. Apparently he's going to run right into that telephone pole. Oh well. Course play doesn't work all the time. And when it does, it's nice, but when it doesn't, it's just silly. You can run to the pool again, aren't you? Yep. Apparently he really likes this pool. How about if I set you behind like this? Whatever. Let's just hop out of here, hop into here. Once it gets started, it's not so bad. I'm just going to stop him for the time being, and then it's going to unload or not. I'm sure he's over there. Apparently he's not over the tipper quite enough for it to unload for whatever reason. There it goes. That's weird. Might as well unload him fully, and then we'll set him on his way again, and then he'll be fine, probably. Just for that reason, sometimes course play gets a little finicky right at the start. It's fine. There we go. It's almost empty. Perfect. We'll hop out of him. Set him. There he goes. Perfect. Let's go check on the New Holland over here. So what we're gonna do is we only didn't get very many bales actually from our hay the last time around. I think we only got I think it was only like 6 or 7 bales. So we may have to rethink the not rethink, but consider changing up the way we do it. So one of the possibilities was picking up another field, perhaps, but there is quite a large area for hay. I think the problem is just the way it's set up with course play, to be honest with you. Just because what happens right now is I think it goes over the same thing twice and actually cuts this stuff more than once. And then it, using the auto swather, it puts it over into a row like this. And I think when it does that, it actually reduces the yield for some reason. I don't know why. That's just the feeling I get, though, for some reason. He's in traffic. What's he doing? Well, try not to tab too much, but apparently there are times when it's required. Like so. Oh, goodness. I'm going to have to babysit this combine, I have a feeling. If I babysit this combine, it should be okay. Let's just get inside of it, then. Yeah, apparently we're going to have quite a high yield on this particular crop. Looks like it was a good combination of fertilizer and whatnot to get a good yield here. Maybe we won't have to worry too much about the drainage issue we're having. Some people in the comments were suggesting that I leave the drainage ditch in because it makes it more realistic, which is true. It does. Although it does reduce the amount of crop we do get to a certain extent. It's not a crazy amount, but it does reduce it to a certain extent. Where is that guy? Oh my goodness. Sure, now you catch up. Always happens. As soon as you stop, that's when the combine, that's when he actually catches up. There we go. Oh well. So we're gonna sit sit with our combine here for a bit, because I don't think we're going to be able to leave it alone, because we're just, there's a crazy amount of soybeans on this field. And if we want to keep this moving at peak efficiency, I think we're going to need to stick around with it. Because I think, I don't know if our Ford's going to be able to keep up with this. Looks like he's not full, but it's hard to say, so. Oh well. So what have you guys been up to lately? Anything interesting? Do you guys have a good New Year's and a good Christmas, I hope? Or if you celebrate any other kind of vacation, holiday, I suppose. What's the other one? Hanukkah, Kwanzaa, anything like that. Hope you guys all had a good, happy holidays. I had a pretty good time, actually. Pretty low-key New Year's Eve, actually. We went to what they call a murder mystery, which is pretty interesting. It's the first time we've ever done it for New Year's Eve. We've done it before, but not for New Year's Eve, so it was pretty cool. They did, like, I think the show started at like 7 o'clock and went to about 10, went to about 9:30, something like that. And it was a pretty good show. We've been to, it was the same people who did one of the other shows we've seen before, so it was good to see how they've changed it up a little bit. It was actually interesting because it was a Charlie Brown murder mystery, which is kind of funny. So in the murder mystery, all of the characters in Charlie Brown had aged considerably, and now they are dealing with some mental issues. It was a pretty good combination, actually, that they put together. It made me laugh more than once. One of the things I like doing the most in those types of murder mysteries or drama like that is when you get to interact with the characters. It's so much fun. Because if you're like an extrovert, I suppose, it's a lot of fun. Because you do get to ask some funny questions and get them to try and say some funny things and see what happens, basically. So that's the part I enjoy a lot. All right, looks like a Ford is just going past the fuel tank. Good. Yeah, so that's what we did for New Year's Eve. Then we came back to my house and played a card game called Saboteur, which is a pretty good little card game, actually. Basically, you either are a saboteur or a miner, and you have to get to the gold is what it boils down to. Pretty cool game. Maybe some of you have heard of it. Maybe some of you haven't. I hadn't played it for number of years. I never knew about it, basically. And then one of my buddies was like, "Hey, have you heard of this game?" And I was like, "No, go check it out." So we did. And ever since then, it's been pretty cool, actually. I think I'm gonna increase the speed of this Ford when he gets here, just so he can keep up. Because I don't think he's in the field right now. I don't know his field speed set to. I think it's pretty slow because I had him cultivating before. I'm just gonna hop over to the Ford, actually. Yeah, it's slow. Where are we here? Let's set him to 20 kilometers and then, or 20 miles an hour, so then he'll be able to actually get there on time. And we'll have to worry about our Ford going back and forth. Such a slow speed. Alright. That's the one thing I don't like about this combine. I never realized it before, because with a hired worker, it's no problem. Actually, I could probably just hire a worker in this case, because it's not going to make a difference because there's no straw or anything. Actually, maybe that's what I'll do. Otherwise, if it's like this, I'm going to have to... Oh, you would too, wouldn't you, Ford? Alright, let's get out of the way here. What I'll do is I'll let the combine do a headland, and then I'll just hire a worker, I think, because I don't need to worry about this guy. There's no straw or anything to pick up. Yeah, if there were straw, I think what we would do is I would leave it via course play, but in this case it doesn't make a difference. Oh yeah, that was totally worth speeding up that Ford. That makes a huge difference. Jeez. He was actually there that time, which is good. Next crop I think we're gonna plant some oats. And the reason for that is, I believe oats, on this map at least, oats do produce straw, which we can bale as well. And oats on this map, they are worth quite a bit, like I mentioned before. 981 $1 a ton regular, which is awesome. So I think what we'll do is we will go oats next time, and if we can indeed get some straw from it, that's going to be fantastic. Alright, so I'm just going to stop the worker, and then, or stop the course play guy, and just hire a worker here. Because, doesn't make a difference here. And then he will actually unload without me having to worry about it. There we go. And we'll check on him periodically, of course, anyways. But I don't know why that, I don't know why it doesn't work in with course play, but it does with a hard worker. That's a really strange, kind of, I don't know, it's a really strange thing, so I don't know why. You do have to manually dump, and that's probably part of the reason why as well, so. Oh well, that is life, I suppose. Alright, let's go check on our New Holland and see how he's doing. So we got 23,000, and we'll probably get quite a bit of money from our soybeans once they're on great demand, which is going to be good, because we're going to need to, I think we're going to need to upgrade a few things. And then we're going to, our cedar is pretty much as upgraded as we can get it without a more powerful tractor. Even with 200 horsepower, we can't technically use any of those cedars that we have. Any of the other cedars, I should say. So that's going to be a bit of a problem. The other thing we need to start considering is a water tank, actually. Let's see what we got for water tanks. Not bailing. What do we have here? A Joskin Aquatrans that holds 3,600 liters for 4,500. What do we have miscellaneous? That's 1,000 liters. This one. That one's, this is only a water trailer though, and I think on this map honestly the breeding stations aren't really worth it because it doesn't take very long to for the crops to mature. That's 8,000, and that will allow us to give our chickens some water finally. And this is 8, so that holds 15,000 liters as well. That's crazy. It's the same price as this one. This one holds another, I guess really doesn't make a difference. They don't need to hold milk, because they don't need to sell our milk on this map. Otherwise, our other options are this one, which is tiny, and we also have another one, which is in tippers. I'm not going to worry about that. I'm just going to get that big one. Yeah. It does drop us down a little bit, but it will make our pigs and our chickens slightly more efficient. And our cows, once we get a cows. Actually, you know what? Let's get a couple cows. We can only get, like, 2 cows. There we go. Let's get 5. There we go. 5 cows. Perfect. So they should start... They should have a certain amount of productivity already, which is good because they have a few things in their troughs already, basically, which is good. All right, let's see how far this guy is. I'm not exactly sure, but at least we have water now, which is good. Oh, he's almost done. I think he's going to do his headland, and then he'll be done, basically. So what we could do is we could... I honestly don't think the Ford is powerful enough to pull that water tanker, because it's an enormous water tanker. I know that for a fact, because I've had that before. I had it on the newbie farm, actually, now that I think about it. And it's a big, big tanker. I would have liked for it to be able to be used with my Kenworth, but that would have cost me, I think it's like 45 grand for any one of them, so. We'll just ask them politely to deliver it, I think. And then we can deal with it. And both of our tractors should be able to pull that. I'm not too worried about that. 4,000, yeah, we don't have anything we can do with 4,000. How far are you, New Holland? Are you almost done? He's almost done. This will be good, because then we'll put him on baling up this hay. And then hopefully we'll get some more hay bales. At least we have silage 2 days, grass 2 days. Whoa, where are you going? Grass 2 days. don't think we'll be able to. We have depleted our straw a little bit here, which is kind of crazy how much we've actually depleted it. I put a couple loads of straw in our mixer here, and I gave our pigs quite a few loads. They are, because we have 89 pigs, they are consuming more straw than I originally anticipated, but it's the way it goes, I suppose. We can give them water as well, but they will consume a lot of water once they are, well, 89 pigs will probably consume quite a bit of water, so I'm just going to wait for that New Holland to finish up, and then I think we'll be good. Let's see if there's anything else. Do we want more chickens? No, I think we're good for chickens now. This was one of the, getting a bee house in the solar panels. We might have been able to get a bee house. I think we're going to need another tractor. I feel it's getting to that time already. We're going to need another utility tractor of some sort. Actually, the next one we're going to need to get is a big, powerful tractor. So I think... yeah, I think this might be... I'll have to see if I can find a good case, an older case tractor that's kind of in a similar price range. Because what do we have in terms of case? Let's just see. Abby, Agrim, Agrivision. Nope. Case, where are you? Every other... Here we are. So we have this one and this one. That's case. And then case IH. So we have these, which are a bit expensive. And I want something in the 100... I could get... I'll have to double check. Because I know I've had that John Deere before, so that's why I'm kind of reluctant to get it again. But it would be nice. Alright, he is doing his last little round here. Let's go tag along here for a second. I shouldn't have made him go to the back to the first waypoint, but he does, unfortunately, so... Oh well, I can always change it, it's not a big deal. So we're gonna tag along with him, doing his last little thing here. And then, yeah, so this is what happens. He goes over, because that's with Courseplay, it goes over the same thing a little bit. And I think because it does that, it actually reduces the amount of grass you get. I'm not sure, not 100%, it just seems that way. So eventually I want to obviously upgrade it to the tower-up mowers. That'll be the nicest option, basically, for us. And he's not in field mode. The only reason he's not in field mode is honestly because of Courseplay. It just works better when it's like this, which is funny that it actually works when it's not in. Is that actually gonna close? No, looks like it's not. It's just funny that it actually works like this. I believe one of the harvesters that we have, the JTF, I think it is. This, or JFCT, it actually won't work unless it's in field position, which makes a lot of sense. And I did pick up another combine. I think I might have mentioned this, I can't remember. This one right here, I actually went and changed the price because they were actually all zero before, which I thought was really silly. But it's a pretty cool combine because this corn header will actually rotate based on the ground, which is really cool. I think this header does it as well. That's at 10.7 meter header, so it's a good combine. It looks all right. It's not the nicest combine, but it's pretty nice. It's the S690i. You can find it on LS2013, I think it is. I actually went and put these prices in, like I said, because had I not, it would have been $0. This is a 10 meter head. How big is this one over here? It doesn't say, does it? 11 meter. That's a 9770. What other options do we have? The New Holland, I suppose. I don't want to get this one. I checked it out a while back. Where is it? This one right here. I checked it out. It's okay. Not amazing, to be honest with you. I don't even know how big this header is, so. I don't like mods that don't provide details. Makes me slightly annoyed. Alright, so he's done now, looks like. I'm just gonna stop him there. Turn off the mower. And then let's go. I can't believe how much quieter it is when you turn that mower off. That's crazy. So we're gonna set him on baling, and then actually what we'll do first is we'll put this away. Like so. Nice little entrance like so. And then we'll back this up. Like that. Perfect. And let's go grab that water tanker and go give our animals some water. Because they're probably a little dehydrated because they haven't had any water yet. And actually what we'll do is... I don't have enough money for that anymore. That's unfortunate. Alright, so we'll give our cows some water. So our cows, pigs, and chickens. Alright, let's take a look at this. For those people who have not seen this, this is one of the mods, the water tanker. Is there fill level? I can't remember. I don't think there's anything you can do on the outside of this mod. No. You can actually unload from the back or unload from the side, which is kind of cool. And you can actually, this arm actually comes down as well, which is kind of cool. Alright, yes, we need to start the engine. This is the one downfall of this particular tractor. If you get out of the tractor, then it will actually turn off. And as you recall, I took off with the wheels, so it's not leaving tracks everywhere. Now, I don't know. We're going to try and fill it from... is there a place we can fill it? Yes, over here. We're going to try and fill it just from the creek here. Or the creek, depending who you're talking to. Let's see if we can. I don't know if we... I'm sure we can, but... if not, I'm not too worried about it, really. Well, you can do it. Doesn't cost you money, but it's kind of silly. Which is good, because that actually makes sense that it doesn't cost you money in this scenario. Although, how far you have to put in the water is a bit silly, but I'm okay with it costing no money. Especially at 15,000 liters, that would have added up probably. I don't know if it's just the trailer itself or if it's just because I'm filling from the creek here, but I do have another mod I could always drop down. I have the, I have the placeable water hydrant. I don't know if it's due to the trailer itself or it's because I'm filling it up from the creek. I don't know, but it's free, so that's good in either case. So let's start off with our pigs, because we're going to drive right past them first. Be on the other side. And what we'll do is as we're giving our pigs some water, we will go check on our combine to make sure he's okay. Is this the water here? Yes, there it is. Alright, I'm just going to go tab to our combine. He's doing alright. This is the downfall of a hired worker, mind you. He stops when he's being unloaded. Oh well, how much soybeans? How many liters do we have already? Nope. Where are we here? 59,000 liters of soybeans already. Just from that. Holy cow. So we're gonna get a metric ton of soybeans. That's crazy. That's good for us because it's gonna mean we're gonna get a good chunk of change, but it also means that I don't know if that's realistic or not. I think some people were saying 45 bushels an acre. I don't know how big this field is. Doesn't say, but it looks like a pretty big field. What is it? 18, 19, 18. 18 is not the same size. Let's go take a quick look at 17, which is down here, just to get an idea of how many hectares it is. Because I'm kind of curious now, because it looks like of similar size. Actually, what we'll do is we'll do that when we're unloading the water for our cows, I guess. All right. Yeah, it looks like our pigs are full of water now. This is good. And of course, it's the wrong barn. Oh well. So that should increase the productivity of our pigs up another 10% or so. Which is good, because then they'll be at 40%, produce a little bit more manure. Oh, they took all of that water? Wow. I'm kind of glad even more now that they don't take... It doesn't cost me to fill up water. I'm just going to try this, because I'm kind of curious. See if it's a trailer or not. It's only a dollar. And if it does cost me something, I'll just go to the creek again. Yeah, let's put it right here. Right there. And let's just see if it is, in fact, the trailer or if it is the creek itself. I'm just curious. Yeah, it's the creek. Oh. That's fine. Let's go fill it up from the creek. Because that makes perfect sense. If you had a creek right there, you probably would fill up water from the creek. Or a well would make a lot of sense as well. I'll have to see if there's a placeable well mod. That'd be kind of cool. It would actually make sense as well. Alright, let's fill this up again. Because apparently our pigs take a crazy amount of water. Like I said, it's good that it doesn't cost anything. Although, I need to find a place with a slightly shallower... Oh my goodness. A slightly shallower... A little less... Not as quite as steep area. Yeah. I'll have to keep an eye out for a good area to do it. Other side looks nice. This side, not so much. That's a little ridiculous. But it is free water, so I can't complain too much about that. Oh, right here would have been fine. Apparently I picked the most difficult place to fill water. Oh well. Let's go take a quick peek. I'm just going to put this guy in a group. Try not to tab too much, but it's a hard habit to break a little bit. Especially when I want to check on things. Alright, let's get out of here. Ooh, he's having a bit of trouble pulling this tanker up there. Sheesh. So let's go give our sheep. We don't have any sheep, which is fine by me. Let's go give our chicken some water. And then we'll swing around and give our cow some water as well. I'm just going to delete that, or sell that, because I have a feeling I'm going to run into it if I don't. At random. Even though it's close to the wall, I'm pretty sure I'll be like, bloop, oh look, there it is. Alright, so this is a, let's see, I'll just show you this particular trailer, how it works on this side. Now it should, I want to use this water, I hope it's this one. No, of course not. Okay, well I can't do it because I'm not going to be able to get drive right beside that, but I can back up, assuming my backing up skills are okay, I guess. There we go. Oh, it's not going to show you. Nope, I guess they have enough water already, so... And the time it took me to actually get out of the tractor and walk around, they got enough water. That's funny. Well, we only have 20 chickens, I suppose. Should have picked up the eggs while we're there. Alright, let's go give our cows. I gotta be careful with this tractor. I totally forget how tippy it is. But that's more realistic, I suppose. Alright, so they'll do it this time. So there's a little arm that comes down, puts water in there. I think that's so cool. Excellent. And let's go give the rest of the water to the pigs, because it was free. No skin off our back is what it boils down to. Alright, no, I don't want to start two pigs up yet. Maybe once we get going, we'll get both buildings up and running at the same time, and then we'll be able to keep one building just for manure, and one building just for selling pigs to the market. There we go. That's a better word than what came to mind first. Good. Alright. So they have, they're full. What I'm going to do is going to just do myself a favor and top this trailer off, and then what I'll do is I'll set this guy up with some baling, because we need to get this baled, because we barely have any hay. It wasn't a very good crop, as I mentioned last time around, so hopefully this time will be better. Let's go take a quick peek here. guess this is all right here. Yeah, it wasn't a very good crop last year, so hopefully this will rectify the situation. But like I said, I think it's mostly course blame. So. All right, is that good? No. There we go. All right, so I think what I'll do is I'll stop the episode there for now. Let's go take a quick peek at our combine. He's doing his thing. This is good. And this is gonna take a while, I think. That's a lot of soybeans. How much do we have now again? 74,000 liters of soybeans. That's crazy. All right, so we're gonna be able to produce a little bit of milk now because our cows do have a little. They are at 80% productivity, which is good. Now that they have water, they might go to 90% productivity. Once we get them those mixed rations, we will be able to get them to 110% productivity, I think it is. All right, so I think I'll stop there. Not sure how long it's been. My name is Ian Robson. This is Farming Simulator 2013, and we're playing on the American farm. Catch you guys later.